With Pages, you have the flexibility of creating all kinds of customized lists. You can have bullet lists, unorganized lists, as well as numbered lists. You can have lists that are in columns, organized as tables, and you have flexibility of customization, not only how the bullet looks, but also how you indent it as well. And I'll show you some of the shortcuts with copying, pasting styles and saving some of the styles that you create in Pages and reuse them. We're going to customize this list of expenses. Select the text and click on the formatting option on the right. If you don't have it open, scroll down to bullets, and we're going to use the text bullets first. And it usually shows up with a default bullet. Now I'm going to add a guide because we're going to customize indents for the bullets. Select the bullets. I'm going to change the bullet to something else, and I'm also going to customize the color for my bullet. Now with the indents, you can control the indent, how the bullet is lined up with the rest of the text, as well as add indent between the bullet and the text. Finally, you can also change the sizing of your bullet. If you just click on the sizing, you can type in the percentage as well as use the arrows to customize it further. What is also really cool is that you can type any symbol in the bullet box and customize. I can do double asterisk, change its size, change its color, and I have a cool, unique bullet. Now, one more alignment I want to show you. By adding guides, I want to show you that you can control the vertical alignment for your bullet. Under bullets, once you select the bullet type, you will have an option that shows up that says align. And you want to align it center, top, or bottom, or what have you, how many points you want to go up or down. Now, what is also cool that you can find any kind of symbol online and copy that Unicode symbol and paste it in a bullet box and use it as your bullet. You just paste the code that you copied from the internet, and then you can also customize it with colors and sizing as any other regular bullet. It's cool to paste different Unicode symbol, etc. But you can also do the same thing with emojis. And I'm going to put a link to this website, which has all kind of Unicode codes as well as emojis. You can copy the emoji, go to your text bullet and paste it. And you can also customize the indents, the sizing. You can't really do much with the color, but otherwise it's pretty flexible. Now, this video wouldn't be complete if we didn't learn how to manually add a bullet. If you click option 8 on your keyboard, you can manually add bullet anywhere in your document. Now, since we're talking about shortcuts, we have to learn how to copy paste styles. Once you figure out the bullet style you like, you can just copy and paste it. You do option command C and option command V to paste the style. You copy the style from one bullet list and paste it somewhere else. We talked about text bullets, but you can also add image bullets, and you have a set of default image bullets in your system. And you can select them and customize by changing color, sizing, indent, etc. But what is even cooler is you can actually add and import your own image. You go to image bullets and under current image, custom image, select the file and import it. And you can customize with indents, sizing, as well as alignment. We talked about unnumbered lists, but you can also create numbered lists by selecting numbers. And you have flexibility of selecting Roman numerals, alphabet, as well as just numbers and different styling. Additionally, you can create multi-level lists if you check the tiered numbers. Then if you select one of the items in your list, and tab it again, it will create a multi-level numbered list, and you can customize it as any other bullet. If you spent a lot of time customizing your bullet list, you may want to save it for future use. And you can go under bullet and list, list styles, and click the plus icon on the right and name your style and click enter. And now you can reuse that style. Sometimes you may want to update the list style. Let's say you have a list style and you've been using it for a while and you want to customize it differently. And now if you go to the list, once you make the changes, you have the update option. Click on that and all the styles using this list will be updated in the document. You can also rename it there. Now, when you are deleting this style, Pages will ask you if you're currently using this style in a document, what do you want to replace it with? Sometimes bullet lists are very short and create a lot of white space. So you may want to customize your list and actually and lay it out in multiple columns. So there's two different ways of doing so. One is after you customize your list, you select the list and go to layout under format. And instead of the one column, you can select two or three or more columns, and you can do this multiple times to your list. Now, the second way to have a multi column layout for your list is with the use of a table. Click on Insert Table, Plain Table, and now in order for the text to be each individual line in each of the rows, you have to have enough rows for the text. So I'm going to add a few more rows and paste my text. The problem with this is that you can't format all the cells at once as bullet list. You would have to go to each individual cell and format it as bullet point. So that's really time consuming. So actually the way to do it is remove all the rows and just leave two, one for the heading and the other one for the list. So once you paste all the lists in your second row, we can format it, copy paste style, and now we have lists in multi columns. However, it still looks like a table. So what we want to do, we actually want to remove the formatting from the table. Go under Format Table, remove the outline, grid lines, and alternating color. And then if there are any borders, you also want to remove that as well. And now you have bullet lists line up nicely in multi columns. Thanks so much for watching.